My name is Mariah. Welcome back to my channel. Or if you are new here, welcome. Today is going to be my first official challenge chat where I pretty much just talk about the most recent episode of The Challenge on MTV. So, episode one of The Challenge Double Agents just aired last night, and I am not lying when I tell you this is the most dramatic premiere I have seen in like years. So what I'm thinking for my challenge chats is that I'm going to break it down into four basic parts. So the challenge, or what they're calling this season, the mission, and then the elimination, where someone gets sent home, and then also any important alliance updates. So if we see anyone start to work together, or maybe people start to fall out. And then also a fourth portion I'm just calling memorable moments. So things that like really stuck out to me, or things that just made me like have my jaw fall to the floor. And there were plenty of those during this episode. First things first, I'm glad that I watched that declassified episode that aired on Monday, because I felt like I got a huge sneak peek into all the challengers, especially the rookies that came in this season. So this episode started off with everyone pretty much just coming into that first daily mission. So from the get-go, we are starting off with that daily mission, and so all the players are pretty much just standing out in the middle of nowhere. So they're filming this season in Iceland. Everyone's in their uniform, ready to go, but they're the only ones there. So in comes this helicopter. Now, I wonder who could be on that. So here comes this helicopter flying in that comes and lands. And here comes TJ looking fly, no pun intended. And he comes out and says, "What's up to everyone? And I'm TJ Lavin, if you don't know me, and this is the challenge double agents." So TJ says that, you know, in order to be an elite agent, you need that social, political, and that physical like edge. So that's giving me like butterflies pretty much. Like, I am pumped. So right away, this episode has me on my toes, and I'm excited for what's to come. So we start right away with the challenge, or as they're calling it, the mission. Mission decryption. Players, what they're doing, there are two heats, a guy's heat and a girl's heat. At the start of the mission, they are running towards a capsule at the top of a hill, and on that capsule, there's going to be a color code. The players need to mimic that code, but once they find that capsule, they find the code, they need to memorize that code, head back to their board, and then put the wires in that correct order. Now, at first I'm like, oh, okay, so a memory game. Seems straightforward enough. However, then I realized, oh, there's literally just one capsule. So it's going to be a physical game. So there's all the players are gonna run up and just go for this one capsule. So right away, what sticks out to me? Lolo. She is an Olympian, so I guess, I don't know why I wasn't expecting that, but she takes off in front of everyone. She's in the lead, and she runs up and she grabs that capsule first. And so this whole challenge is pretty much neck and neck. Of course, you can never tell with the way that it gets edited on the show, but it seems like it's kind of neck and neck. Is it Lolo's game? Is it Tori's? Anissa is kind of up there, and she has it checked a couple times. Other players are having it checked, and they're like, no, it's wrong. So it's kind of hard to tell who is really in the lead. One thing that was kind of weird is it seemed that Nicole Z and Lolo were working together, because Nicole was calling out to Lolo like, "Lolo, what's the color?" So I'm not sure what that is about yet. Those two were not paired together in my alliance prediction video. So, although it's neck and neck, Anissa pulls out the win, and I am pumped. I'm like, yeah, girl, show them what's up. Because as you know, if you are a longtime challenge viewer, Anissa has been on there forever. She has just been there for so long. She knows the game. Everyone knows her. And she is, you know, just a well-known vet. But people always count her out. The guy's heat is like something else. I mean, it's like super physical. The girl's heat, I feel like, wasn't as physical, but the guy's heat is like just physical. Like, I mean, pile and pile of guys on each other. And again, just kind of neck and neck that whole time. Obviously, if you watch the episode, this was probably the funniest moment of the whole episode. CT threw a shoe out of his way, like someone lost their shoe, ends up hitting Wes in the face. So I was actually laughing out loud. I feel so bad. So sorry, Wes. Again, seems super close, but Fessy pulls out the win. So good job, Fessy. not super surprised because obviously Fessy is a great competitor. He made it to the finals last season. All the players are standing around. TJ congratulates Fessy and Anissa for winning. And then you come to find out that there was actually just one overall winner, pretty much who finished the challenge the fastest. Like, oh, Fessy. No, it was Anissa. So Anissa was the overall winner of the day. She is going to get a huge advantage. Because she was the overall winner, so twist number one, she gets to pick her partner. TJ tells us it's a team game and you're gonna be partnered up with someone. So then I'm like, okay, so guy-girl pairs, I'm assuming. And so he says, yeah, so I want you to pick a guy partner. She's looking at the whole stack of guys. I mean, we have CT, Wes, Darrell, Fessy, Corey, Nelson. I mean, really, anyone is great to choose from. In the end, Anissa picks Fessy. And I feel kind of bad for her because none of the guys really seemed like they wanted to be picked by Anissa. Like I mentioned, you know, they just know that she doesn't have the endurance as much as some of the other girls. But she's great at puzzles. She's smart. She's kind. She's very upfront and down to earth. So I think that could really be a good advantage for her this season. So then I'm like, okay, I wonder if they timed every single person. And so they're just going to go down the stack, maybe like every other guy and girl. And they'll just pick someone until, you know, last man standing. But then TJ says, okay, pick your partner. Like, pick your partner. And they're just like, huh? And then they're like, oh, shoot, okay, you're serious. Like, okay. So people just start grabbing people. They're like, who do you want to work with? Tori and Corey pair up right away. You know, other people are kind of looking around, and I'm just noticing a little bit, like, some people aren't really, like, getting drawn to other people right away. Like, Darrell, you know, some of the girls weren't going to him right away, and I think people maybe just aren't as familiar with him. I'm not sure why they're not going to him right away. I would think he would have a couple people, like, lined up right to him. CT even called out for Tori, it seemed like, and she was already paired up with Corey. And Cam, I thought, you know, it showed Cam and Leroy go towards each other at first, so I thought, oh, cool, like, power couple. Cam and Leroy are going to be together. And they're like, no, we don't want to actually be on the same team because easy target, let's split up. So Cam runs up to CT and says, hey, let's work together. And CT's like, why? Like, give me a reason. He's almost just like, sell me on it. Like, why should I work with you? And I'm thinking like, well, that's kind of weird. Like, one, I kind of feel bad for Cam. I mean, she has thick skin, so I'm sure it really didn't bother her or anything like that. I'm super sensitive, so I probably would have had my feelings hurt. But, I mean, she is like, I'm a great competitor. Like, politics, social game, I'm strong. My endurance is good. I mean, you know, why wouldn't you want to work with me? And he's just kind of like, eh. And then he walks away and then finds Ashley. So I'm like, okay. I mean, I feel like Ashley has a big target on her back. So I don't know if I would have picked Ashley. But anyway, I'm going to post the teams here for you. All right, so one thing about this season, it seems like there's no like last place team. It seems like that first place team, so as of today, Anissa and Fessy, they are pretty much like, they're calling them the double agents. So they are the almost, they're the winners. They get the advantages, they get the power. There's not necessarily a last place team that automatically gets thrown in. Crater, they're calling it, or the elimination. So instead, the house is just going to vote. So they can throw in whoever they want. They can throw in the second place team that almost won the challenge. That's kind of a twist in my opinion, because it's like, usually if you perform the worst, you should probably go into the elimination, but nope, not this season. The house is voting, so the house is gonna vote in private, and right away people are saying, let's get CT and Ashley in there. And by people, it kind of seems like Cam and Leroy are leading that brigade, but everyone's kind of for it. And in all honesty, I'm like, okay, it makes sense. And I'm kind of mad at CT because he didn't pick Cam, and now Cam's with Josh, and I don't even like Josh. I like Cam, so now I have to root for Josh. So now they're voting, they have to vote. Some people are kind of arguing, you know, you're supposed to throw the rookies in though, mostly Ashley. Ashley's like, you know, you gotta go in there, you gotta earn it. This is just challenge tradition. You gotta go in if you're a rookie. But, you know, people are saying no. Like Leo, he's like, I'm not scared of you, CT, so I'm gonna vote for you. So drama is already going down on episode one. When it comes to it, they all cast a vote in private, which is also huge because it's like, you know, you can't even, you're not even showing your cards. You can say one thing and then go do another thing. So you can basically lie to anybody and do something completely different. So when it came down to it, the majority of the house actually voted for CT and Ashley to go into elimination. Now, what are one of these advantages of being a double agent or being that first place team? Well, they get to see who voted for the team to get thrown in. And they get to see who the team is ahead of time. So CT and Ashley, they didn't know they were even getting thrown in until it came time to do the elimination. So Anissa and Fessy got to go into this private room, they got a sneak peek, and they saw the compromised agents were CT and Ashley. So they already knew. And then all the people came up on the screen who voted for them, and they got to see everyone. So this is another huge twist, and Anissa was very, very smart. She said, no, we're not telling anyone about this twist. So it's going to be interesting to see how the game unfolds, because as more and more people start winning, more and more people are going to be aware of this secret power where they get to see who votes for who. So I wonder who's going to spill the beans, because eventually this isn't going to be a secret anymore. Eventually someone's going to know, oh crap, they're getting to see who votes for who. So I hope it lasts as long as possible, because that's a huge twist. You can get some really good intel from this twist. So when it comes down to the elimination, obviously Ashley and CT get notified that they're going in. Now, instead of like previous seasons where the team that is down there in the crater, they can't just pick a team that's up there. That's not how it's working this time. This time, the double agents, Anissa and Fessy, are picking another team. So right now I'm thinking, wow, they just get the short end of the stick. They're in the elimination and they don't even get to pick who they're going against. Who do they pick? Wes and Natalie. Anissa's like, you know what? I'm tired of playing a scared game. I haven't ever got a challenge win. And the only way to get it is to go big or go home. I'm voting for Wes and Natalie. And then I'm like, because Wes and CT are both on my list of people I wanted in the final. So right away I'm like, oh great, one of my two favorites are going home. So I'm shocked, but then I'm also like, wow, this is crazy, like in a cool way. There's just so much to unpack, right? So then in the biggest, at this point, the biggest twist, they say it's a girls elimination. And I'm like, girls elimination? What does that mean? So I'm like, so you have two teams here and then it's up to the girls to compete and then they get to decide the fate of the whole team? So I'm like, well, then that's not even exciting. Then it's just Natalie versus Ashley and then that's it. But then I'm just like, or does that mean only a girl's going home? Elimination in the crater. They're hanging from this rope. They have to go down to one end and then the other, and there's a hump in the middle, so it's really hard, and it's really hard to get the hang of it. It's pretty much neck and neck this whole time, and I'm really thinking that it's anyone's game. It seems like it's super exhausting, and even though Natalie does start inching ahead, Ashley is refusing to give up, and in the end, it is like seeming so close, but Natalie pulls ahead and Natalie wins. So Natalie wins a gold skull, so then I'm like, okay, so Natalie and Wes don't win a gold skull. It's just that single individual. So I'm like, okay, so Ashley's for real going home. And TJ says, yeah, sorry, Ashley, this ends your time on the challenge. And I'm like, what is going on? I'm like, okay, so Ashley's going home. Now the teams are going to be uneven. So what does that mean for CT? Then the biggest freaking bombshell of the episode, TJ says, well, Natalie, winning means you have power. And now she can pick to keep Wes as a partner. She can instead have CT as a partner. Or she can steal anyone else's partner, except for the double agent, so except for Fessy. So I'm just like, what? So you're telling me every single week partners can get changed around. So you can't rely on your partner at all. I don't know. I need to know what's going to happen. And of course, they freaking cut it off and left it with a cliffhanger. So going forward, we know that in the extended previews and even the preview from next week, we see CT on there. So my intuition is telling me Natalie is going to pick CT. And the reason why I think that is because she was already targeted with Wes as a partner week one. So maybe she's going to go ahead and switch to CT. But what I'm wondering is, what if she picks like someone else? So let's do a hypothetical. Say she picks someone else as partner. Say she picks Corey. So then that leaves Tori. Then Tori needs a partner. So then does that mean Tori gets to pick from Wes or CT? Then she would pick one and then the other person goes home? I think that's how it's going to be. So even if your partner wins the elimination, you're sitting there wondering if you're going to go home. So you can't even really trust your partner. I don't know. My mind is blown. I truly think this might be one of the dirtiest seasons ever, one of the best seasons ever based on the first episode. I'm super freaking pumped. Let me know your thoughts below. So looking at my notes here real quick, for alliance updates, I was correct in predicting that Wes and Natalie were going to work together. That was just a prediction. I had no clue they were even going to like team up and be partners, but we'll see how that plays out after this week. It seems like Nicole Z and Lolo might be, you know, doing some type of alliance deal. Not 100% sure. And then before this episode aired, this was my alliance prediction chart. But this was before I knew that there were going to be partners for sure. And this was before I knew that partners were going to switch around every week. So I have no clue what's going to happen now. There's too many possibilities. Those that were already in an alliance, they might not ever want to switch partners. So they might try to stick with their partners throughout the whole season, but then someone not in their alliance might come in and completely shake things up. So let me know your thoughts. As for memorable moments, I wrote down CT turning down Cam. Again, I just said it was memorable just because it was kind of like funny but sad, because she like went right up to him and he was like, why? Like an interview, like, why should I hire you? And then I also said Wes said he was in an alliance with every dude in the house. So then that would also be interesting if Natalie decides to switch partners, because CT is definitely not in an alliance with every guy in the house. Oh, and then the last memorable moment I have marked down is that TJ said there are 10 gold skulls total. So one's already gone. So there's only 9 left. So, they better get to work. So yeah. So that's it for this week of my challenge chat, my episode 1 recap of the challenge 36 double agent. Super excited about this season. Like I said in my last video, this is the first season where I haven't really seen official spoilers. Sometimes I see them like on some Instagram pages or Twitter, so I'm trying not to like go down the rabbit hole or anything too much. So please don't spoil anything below, mostly for others that are watching this video, but also for me as well. So, but other than that, thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Subscribe if you don't want to miss my next challenge chat, and I will see you in my next video.